The 2014 World Cup is kicking off in just over a month's time. Today, the BBC is revealing how you'll be able to watch all of the games 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. We're here at the launch event to see exactly how the BBC is going to do this. I know next to nothing about football, so let's go and talk to some people who do. The BBC says that Brazil 2014 will be the first 24/7 World Cup ever. Every game shown on BBC TV will be available on catch-up or on the BBC Sports site. But that's not all the BEEB has up its sleeve for the World Cup. Neil Hall, future media support at the BBC, is here to tell us more.
For BBC Sport, this is the first 24/7 World Cup, and digital is right at the heart of that proposition. We'll offer enhanced live coverage, breaking news, and a range of interactivity, all on any device at any time throughout the tournament. We have great video rights to this event. We're showing every goal across four screens, and you'll also be able to download daily highlights packages via BBC iPlayer, so you can relive the best bits from the games in the evening on the way to work. We've updated our scores so that you'll have faster than ever data in this experience. You'll have in-game highlights, so say you've come in half an hour late, you'll be able to flip through the best bits of the action or watch them again at half-time at your leisure. We'll also be offering alternative commentaries, so you could watch the BBC Sport TV pictures with the Five Live radio commentary, and there are also some two player cams options, so you can follow players around the pitch, perhaps while you're watching the main action on your big screen. Ahead of the tournament, there's a great chance for you to see all this functionality in action with our World Cup Rewind feature. So we'll be replaying five classic Home Nations World Cup matches in the true BBC Sport digital style. So you'll be able to watch the games live, enjoy live text commentary, and join in the discussion around that via social media.
We asked legendary commentator John Motson for his thoughts on the role social media can play in the World Cup.
Well, I think it's a sign of the times, because there's more social media and all sorts of outlets now that weren't there even 4 years ago when the World Cup was in South Africa. So I think this Brazilian World Cup is going to break new ground. I think the 24/7 thing is very important, because I think people can now access what they want to see and hear on whatever day they happen to want to do that, by all sorts of different methods, and they can pick their own time. You know, when I started at the World Cup, you had to watch the match while it was on, and if you missed it, too bad, you know. And then we got video recorders, and so it went on and on. And now I think, as I said, it's given people a maximum amount of choice. I think the two-way hashtag thing, all the different methods you can now react by Twitter and things like that, they've all happened in the last 2 or 3 years. So we haven't had a World Cup quite like that before. So I suppose the word I'm looking for is interactive. That's what it's going to be. And that gives everybody a chance to express their opinion. The platforms that we've now got has changed the way people watch, absorb, and form opinions about football.
As well as delivering the World Cup to viewers in a new and unique way, the BBC will be broadcasting live matches on BBC One, BBC Two, and BBC Three in standard and high definition.
Das war ein Befehl! Der Angriff steigt, das war ein Befehl! Versteht Sie?
You've got things like Catch Up, home of BBC iPlayer, 4OD, Watch, Dave, Sky TV On Demand, and you've got box sets.
And we're determined to keep both the Android and iOS versions of iPlayer lockstep, so there'll be no gap in functionality or features. So